yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it, but you got it all, believe it. When you fold it up, oh-oh, and if you fold it up, eh-eh, tamina, mina, sangalewa, cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh-eh, waka, waka, eh-eh, tamina, mina, sangalewa, this time for Africa. To shine, don't wait in line, vamos por todo. People are raising their expectations. Go on a feed and this is your moment, no hesitation. Today's your day, I feel it. You pave the way, believe it. If you get down, get up, oh, oh. When you get down, get up, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. Waka, waka, eh, eh.
Incredible vertical leap to snatch birds out of the air. They hunt rodents, small birds, and small deer. Their social structure is solitary and terrestrial. A male's territory usually overlaps those of several females. They are active at night. The caracal's habitat is in the woodlands, the savanna, dry grasslands, and the scrub forests.
This is Kristen, and she's a keeper here at the zoo, so we're going to ask her a couple questions.
Kristen, what do you feed the caracals?
Today, the caracals are getting a raw beef in mixed in with a little bit of dry cat chow. They also get mice, some mice that we thaw out and feed out, and that's what Rebecca was actually scattering around the yard. Yesterday, they got bones, so twice a week they get beef bones. Sometimes they get fish. And once a week on Mondays they get rabbits, and those we get, they're already dead, they're frozen, and we feed them out when they're thawed out.
Do you train them when they're young to
We do. We actually got these guys as adults. They came to us from two separate zoos, and so we didn't actually raise them here. These guys, caracals are very territorial and aggressive animals. We don't go in with them at all, so Rebecca was out in the yard putting the food out. The caracals are shut in their dens. They wouldn't be able to kill you necessarily, but they're just, as a species, they're very, very aggressive. So even through training, we can get certain behaviors from them, like they show their paw pads and we check their teeth. They're trained to go into a special chute for injections and things, but we don't physically go in with them. And we've tried, actually, to train them to be less aggressive with no success.
What are the genders of these two who are in here?
We have a male and a female. The male is 10 years old, his name is Kabaru, and the female is Martina, and she's actually 14. I'm sorry, Kabaru is 12. And so we've been keeping them together for the past couple of years now and hoping that they would produce kittens. So far they've bred, but they've never produced kittens. But we're still hopeful that eventually we'll have little careful kittens running around.
That's great. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Are fresh food and water readily available to the animals? Where?
There's a water bowl in the right hand of the cage. There's also a rain well. This naturally collects rain.
What kinds of exercise are available to the animals? Why is this a good or bad form of exercise?
Well, he has a roof that looks like he can play on. And he also has lots of logs to climb on. And these are important because it's I learned that the caracal, when he's getting his food, he jumps vertically so the rope can help him with that, and then he likes to climb also when he's stalking prey. And the rope over there, it looks like you can tie food on it or something. And the caracal will jump to it, and if this is useful because in real life for the caracal, they jump up vertically to catch birds, and so they'll jump up vertically to catch their meat.
Does the animal appear healthy? What elements might contribute to this?
Yes, it looks healthy because it appears that it gets enough food, water, and exercise. Also because he can climb up, the animal can climb up the trees and exercise.
As a visitor, do you have any fears or observations about the safety of the enclosure?
As a visitor, I'm not really concerned with any safety because the fences around the enclosure are all really high, and then it's also on top, so I'm not worried about any safety issues. And there's an electric wire going through, so the animals won't even try to get out the cage.
Yeah. Interesting. Does the enclosure give the real life impression? How?
The enclosure does give the visitors the real life impression because you see all these rocks over there? It looks like the natural habitat that the caracal have, and all those trees they place like the caracal's home in the wild place.
What precautions do the keepers appear to take? Do they carry anything?
No, keepers take a lot of precautions, including they wait for the animal to go inside their cage, and then they bring their cleaning gadgets inside the cage.
So they put the animal in a cage while they're cleaning up and taking care of it. Anything else?
Very cool.
Anything else?
No.
Cool, right?
This is Natalie with her conclusion.
We had a slight problem with the visibility of the caracals. We couldn't see them for a while before they came out. Their habitat is very realistic and looks like the one in the wild. Here's some fun facts about the caracals. Did you know that each of their ears is controlled by 20 muscles, which helps them better find where their prey is hiding? In the wild, they live for about 12 years, but when they are enclosed and taken care of by humans, they may live up to even 17 years. Remember to become a member of FONS, Friends of the National Zoo.